Lucy said, the last time I spoke at one of these events, I was still incarcerated. But thanks to a lot of you and thanks to God, I was released on the 3rd of February this year. Institution I went to was Georgia State Prison, which they called Reedsville back then, and it was nicknamed the White Elephant. I still don't know why today, but the building was white at that time. But anyway, the one thing that I did was able to hold on to for my freedom was the ability to draw. And when I was 4 years old, I was drawing. By the time I was 10, I was drawing portraits of my sister. And one day my mother walked by and she said, called me Bubba. She said, Bubba, you're gonna be an artist. And at the time, I didn't even know what an artist was, but if my mama said I was gonna be one, I was gonna be one. So, but anyway, when I was at Georgia State Prison, I learned that they had an art contest there. So I entered the contest and I ended up placing 3rd. And I was proud of that, but something about having first place just ain't the same. Third, but it motivated me. And I spent a lot of time trying to develop that talent, that gift that God had blessed me with. Time went on. I ended up at another prison in, I think it was Frank Scott in Millersville. And they had a faith-based program there that they were just starting up, and they wanted guys who could teach different classes. So I got in there and I taught my first art class there. And I think I taught art classes for the next 20, 25 years in the system everywhere I went. And it was always good to have someone run up on someone, and they said, Fred, I'm so glad I took that art class, man. A lot of guys in the system don't have support. So they make their support with different little things they can do. And the guy said, man, look, I'm drawing now, I'm getting paid. You know, people paying me to draw now. So that was real special for me. But I continued to draw and teach guys how to draw. I never did think I could paint. And I got transferred to Smith State Prison. And I got transferred there to aid the art class there. And one of the officers wanted to paint a portrait of herself done. And the instructor said, well, get Fred. So I didn't back down from the challenge, but I never painted a portrait. But I learned that day that I could paint. And I painted that portrait of her, and another staff member was getting another guy to do hers, but we always kept the artwork covered up. And when it was time for them to pick them up, they got a first look at them, and that lady she just cried. She was just blown away by that. It just meant the world to me to see that someone could get that emotional over something that I did. And I've seen that happen several times from my artwork. I won't call that names. She raised her hand. But it's just been a blessing all the way through my incarceration, which was a total of 36 years, that artwork foundation for me that held me together. And it They saw some of the artwork I did at the mansion, and they invited me to one of these shows to help them set up and whatnot. And while we were setting up, we were stepping back and forth. Just so happened, we ended up going in the same direction. And I said, well, I'm gonna try to start art class at the center. And she said, do you have a sponsor? And I'm like, a sponsor? I mean, what? She kind of caught me off guard, but when she plugged into that, oh my God. There was nothing that I needed, anything she thought I needed, it was there. Totally supportive. And at our graduations, we might have 5 or 6 guys graduating art class, but our guest speaker would be the governor and the first lady. I think that was pretty awesome. I'm pretty sure they turned down some invitations where they could have been in a lot better setting. But they took the time to come there and support us and her. And even the first lady now was at the last graduating class, so it turned out to be a pretty big event there. But art has been a foundation for me, and I feel good about being able to pass it on to so many people. Some of the artwork that I've seen up there might be some guys that I got started. I don't remember them all, but I know they fell in love with it, and it helped them, and it helped me. I don't want to be long-winded, but you know, when you get a certain age, and I just had a birthday this month, I turned 68. But you start looking back at your life, and you try to see some things where you did good, some things you didn't do so good. So I look back and I started grading myself, and I got a few D's and C's and maybe a B or two here and there. But I couldn't find that A plus. As I look back, I kept on looking. And I just, what did I do in my lifetime that would deserve an A plus? And the one thing that I got an A plus in was something I never learned how to do. Still don't know how to do it today. And that's be a quitter. I never learned how to quit. I never learned how to give up. That's because of people like the BBC here, the commissioner, just that long journey brought me to this place. There were a lot of times I didn't think I'd get here. And I really wanted to quit, wanted to give up. But I would pick up those pencils and pull my little art pad out and go to work and look like everything else would just be all right. And it brought me through a lot. That gift that God gave me. And in the Bible they say when you get a talent, God bless you, good one. He don't want you to put it on a stone and hold it and hide it. He wants you to use it. And I tried to use mine. It was all I had to use. And I like the fact that I used it to the fullest in the system and still using it out here today. And I just want to thank everyone. Thank you for giving me a chance to speak. Well, the bridge over there is the Pettus Bridge that John Lewis and them marched on. And I know there's a movement trying to get the name of that bridge changed to John Lewis, so it motivated me to put his name on that bridge, just in case. And the next one with the angel there, that's the Ghost Twin Towers. That's a guardian angel. plum she's putting into the chamber of her wings. And the big mouth bass, I love the fish. So my lady Tony, she'll tell you pretty much every day if I could, I'd go fishing. Haven't caught that one yet, but I'll get closer. And I think that's the third eagle I've drawn painted there and like that. And one of them is hanging up in the Capitol building. But I had a chance to go see it hanging in her office, and she had a sign put up over it, scripture put up over it. I think it was something about mounting up on the wings of eagles or something like that. But I'm sure some of you are familiar with that scripture. And the lady, the warden, I'm sorry, I kind of forgot to say. But Andrew mentioned the fact that you do what you do for the art there. Well, the people along the way, when I started out, all the wardens, the whole administration, they support anything with art and crafts. They embrace that. So I'm glad to see you taking it up to another level, but I want you to know that at the other institutions, so it was so easy for me to get an art class going. All I had to do was ask. And I want to applaud you for allowing the guy to really get a chance to show the talents off. Because when you got a talent, it took me a while to learn this. Because you always think about the monetary things and stuff. But eventually, if you're an artist, whether it's painting, dancing, singing, whatever, it's that recognition. Even in business, you just want to be recognized. So recognition is important, and I appreciate you for what you do, for allowing those guys to be recognized. I thank you all for giving me a chance to speak, and I hope I say the right things.